term that may not ring a bell, femicide. That's when someone is killed due to domestic violence. Last year, it happened 37 times in Minnesota. Today at the state capitol, lawmakers and domestic violence support groups are hoping to give law enforcement more tools to handle the issue. Our Catherine Johnson joins us now live at the capitol with more on what's going on there today. Catherine.
Steve, here's that list that you were just talking about, the list of 37 names of victims who have been killed by domestic abuse over the past year. Now, there are lots of statistics in this packet. It breaks these names down from geographical location to these victims' relationship to their abuser. And what hurts the most to see, the numbers that are growing year to year.
Even though she had relocated her entire life, she worried, would he be released 5 minutes or 5 hours away?
One in three Minnesota women will be in a situation like this at some point in their lives.
Then 24 hours later, he would return and abuse her again.
Here in Minnesota, we know three of these stories all too well. Anna Rae Shunk, Mandy Matula, and Kira Steger. Those are just three of the 37 names listed in the Minnesota Coalition for Battered Women's annual femicide report. All victims of deadly crimes of domestic or sexual violence in just the past year.
16-year-old Anna Hurd was attempting to break up with her boyfriend, but stated she was afraid of what he might do.
Legislators and law enforcement gathered at the Capitol to gain speed before introducing two new bills in the 2014 session. House File 2141 would allow police more than the current 24-hour deadline to find offenders and arrest them without a warrant.
Over half of the victims in the 2013 report experienced prior abuse.
House File 2142 would notify victims of their attacker when they get out of prison, letting them know where they'll be.
Law enforcement needs sufficient time to apprehend and arrest domestic violence perpetrators when they flee the scene of a domestic violence crime.
The MCBW says it could have been the difference between life and death for the 37 women memorialized on this list.
Janae knew approximately when he would be released from prison, but the law said she couldn't know where he would be released when he got out. His release date arrived. The next day, he was outside Janae's home. He had found her.
Now, the people on this list are only the ones that we know about. The coalition's also saying so many victims never come forward. So they're actively reaching out into schools, housing services, hospitals, trying to find more victims that are too afraid to come forward so they can get this word out and try to knock that number down next year. Live at the state capitol, Catherine Johnson, 5 Eyewitness News.
Yeah, certainly hope to see that number come down.